Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue All Items Taken Week here with our first Eden run of the theme week. Thank you all very much again for making this possible. Oh boy, let's see what we got in store for today. But first, here's your meme of the day brought to you by Green-Eyed Monster 1986 on this Invicta subreddit titled, Finally Started Therapy. Oh, they put a lot of time into this one as well. So how was your week? It was the first time he said, how you doing, sissy, and it just didn't bother me, you know? Felt no shame or resentment at all. I love it. I like that Dark Bum is more receptive of his bigger sister, little sissy. Yeah, there you go. So thank you very much, Green-Eyed Monster 1986, and all 150 of you who upvoted that one. Here we go. Random run day in the bag now, and we're looking, okay, more towards a standard Eden run. CJ is going to be Zulu, Yankee, Papa, Alpha, Whiskey Tango Alpha 1. We've got Pinky Eye. We also have Conquest Pony. Oh, my God, our tiers rate. It is absolutely abysmal. 1.94. At least our damage is okay. We got tiers down and shot speed up. All right, so starting off with a tiers rate of 1.55. And somebody on the YouTube Mosh Pit comments mentioned that it's probably a better way to phrase how the pills are going to be handled for this week as we take all – as we identify all unidentified pills. That's the better way to think about it. Because then it goes from, like, we take all pills to, oh, yeah, we're taking and identifying all unidentified pills. That's the better way to think about that. So, but with a tiers rate this bad, especially after getting, of course, a tiers down on the very first pill that we take, is pretty awful, I got to say. And we're going to start off with an orbital and yeehaw, here we go. Curse the maze. I mean, Conquest Pony at least is going to help us out a little bit with boss killing and stuff. But, yeesh. We're going to need some tiers rate upgrades in a big way. Hopefully there's a tiers up pill somewhere in the pool. Speed up doesn't really matter, but hey, it's good if we end up having to replace the flying pony with an active item, which I'm sure we probably will. Curse of the Maze just skipped us 4 billion rooms ahead of us, so we need to, not entirely sure if we need to backtrack to find our item room or not. Obviously, with Devil Deals here, it's going to be a little bit limited because we don't have a whole lot of HP, so okay, and we're just going to go straight to the boss, I guess. Curse of the Maze, everyone. Cat of Nine Tails. I'm actually not going to take a Devil Deal here. We can't take one even if we like wanted to. So I'm just going to go ahead and ignore it. And if the game allows me to, I will eventually, hopefully, find our item room through our back-to-back Curse of the Maze procs. So yeah. So you know, we got Cat of Nine Tails. It's a great damage upgrade. Great shot speed upgrade. But again, the problem is just the simple fact of just having no fire rate at all. And that's a big, big problem here. We've seen a lot of tinted rocks, but no bombs, unfortunately. Get Twanky Twanky, which is immediately going to shoot down our damage. And, we got Birthright in here, which we don't really have a chance of getting. Because we needed a bomb to get these tinted rocks. And it gave us 2 soul hearts, so yeah. All right. Well, Curse of the Maze somewhat saved us some time, I guess. But, I mean, we could, with flying, we should try to find something that can help us get Birthright. The problem is that 2020 now just pretty much cut off our only big advantage, which was our early game damage here. And now, yes, we do still have the advantage of having 2020, of course, but we no longer are doing overwhelming amounts of damage to where we can one-shot all these, like, sort of, like, you know, these regular mobs that we normally wouldn't be one-shotting, but we'd be, like, having easier time one-shotting. Okay, so backtracking proved to be pretty much useless. I mean, we did gain another soul heart for it, so not totally useless, but we would have to exactly find the item, the secret room, have lots of money in it. It's not going to be in there. There's another tinted rock here, though. Just as a soul heart, so yeah. All right, well, you know, We can still, well, we can look in the devil deal now. And away we go. Excuse me, I had to take a sip of water. Throat's been rather dry today. We have Beth's Essence, which is going to give us a five wisps at the start of the next floor if we end up not replacing it with another trinket. But you kind of see what I was talking about here with not being able to like totally one-shot things. Here, these Globins are a good example. Yes, we have the multiple shot of 2020, but now they are packing 30% less of a punch, or 20% less of a punch, which is a pretty significant downfall for us here. And because we don't have the fire rate to back up having such a damage down, we're being punished even more for that. So our shot speed's good, though. I mean, you know, and we still have flying and Conquest Pony. Conquest's Pony is going to still keep us in the clear for bosses for a little while anyway. Seagram should be here. A little bit of a risk using our only bomb for that, but Binge Eater. Well, Binge Eater cannot give us a Tears Up, but it can give us a... Well, no, it's not entirely true. Can Binge Eater give us Tears Ups? Or am I thinking of Keeper Sack? I know Keeper Sack cannot give us Tears, but Binge Eater can give us a lot of stats that we desperately are needing right now. It is going to kill our movement speed, but the thing is that the movement speed isn't going to really matter with us having Conquest Pony. Now, the problem is that if we find another active item, then it really does matter. but for the time being, yeah. Lots of pills here. Get a luck up. Sack of pennies going off for us. Appreciate that. Still looking for item room in our shopperino. That's just satisfying as all get out right there. Using Conquest Pony. In a big room where it can just laser down everything. So we're very highly incentivized to find item pedestals now because we have Binge Eater. And Binge Eater can, again, it can provide us with some much-needed damage, much-needed, I think, tears. But, of course, also give us those juicy, juicy Binge Eater buffs that we all know and love. So one more scent, and we can get our first Binge Eater item here. Get Big Chubby. Big Chubby. Soul Lilith. This is a permanent familiar, which is pretty cool. But my god, do we need a Tears Rate upgrade? 1.55 is just... It's torturous, even, I would say. So, goodbye Beth's Essence. Hello, Poker Chip. We have to replace it. There we go. We get 15 cents, so we can get our first Binge Eater item now. Get our second Binge Eater item here. It's gonna give us damage and shot speed up. Degas gives us half of a soul heart. We can go into the shop and get the second Binge Eater item here, which is gonna give us some more. It gives us more deal with the devil fodder. So we get more damage and more shot speed. So again, our shot speed is gonna be pretty impressive, but without having the tears rate to back it up, it's not nearly as good as it could be. We get perfection, so goodbye to the poker chip. Yeah, we'll take a binge eater here. It did give us a tears up, so that's good. We'll take duality and a binge eater. Look at that. We are able to get two back-to-back tears ups. That's huge. All right. 2.84 damage now. And Binge Eater single-handedly, I mean, getting us back in the swing of things here, which, you know, again, is a testament to how good the item is. And of course, your mid-episode reminder, if you are enjoying these videos or if you just want to generally support my channel, all you gotta do is just click the like button. It takes less than a second to do, totally free. And it also greatly helps out the channel with the YouTube algorithm and all that kind of good stuff. And thank you to those of you who do go out of your way to do that. I really appreciate it. It keeps the channel going, and thank you again. Well, we could take Thunder Thighs or we could take Binge Eater. Red Stew or Binge Eater. I mean, if we have the choice, I'll take Red Stew. For now. This is kind of where it starts getting a little bit... With Binge Eater, it kind of gets a little bit... it gets a little bit muddy with All Items Taken Week. Because it's never... I never really defined what the rule would be with Binge Eater. I think that it's just... It's kind of going to be just a judgment call, really. You know, if we find a fun item, I won't purposely avoid bad items. But if they're like, if it's just like an HP upgrade for an HP upgrade, you know, I'm gonna be like, yeah, I just lost perfection. I didn't think that we were gonna get hit over here. So like right now, we definitely want the tears up over Binge Eater for sure. So yeah. Nothing super crazy yet so far anyway on All Items Taken Week outside of a couple of bad pills. By the way, thank you for everyone who supported the Tiny Folks video. I most likely will be doing at least a follow-up. It remains to be seen how well a series would do on that on the channel there. But I was surprised. It did get a genuine smile out of me for a lot of people saying that, oh, it's great to see you playing another game other than Isaac. I'm like, I played other games than Isaac for years and years and years. It was only the last couple of years where Isaac was, you know, the only game that we really played here. Let's say I didn't think that was the other one. They're hiding from me. I was thinking about Conquest Pony, of course, with big rooms, we just get the instant full recharge. So if we do happen to have a couple of XL rooms back to back, we can simply just use it again. We are rocking and rolling. All systems go here on our first Eden run of All Items Taken Week. And I do have a couple things in mind for the next like streak goal. Once we get our first video past 5,000 likes, we'll be announcing it on the following video after that. I've already identified puberty, so you can take puberty pills, like, you get an HP upgrade, you get the adult transformation, which is an official transformation in the game now. So, you know, if you need another HP upgrade, then, you know, sure. There's no downside to it, really. It just makes Isaac's hair look stupid. We'll take the half-price soul heart. We don't know what this pill is. Let's see forever. And Binge Eater. Gives another huge tears up. This feels like we're going towards the boss, and we are. Got plenty of time to make a boss rush. But you know, when it's All Items Taken, it's like at any point we could get like Isaac's Heart or Cursed Eye or something like that, where it's just guillotine. It's just gonna it's gonna be all kinds of bad. Take eye drops. I will go into the angel deal here. Celtic Cross. I mean, Vegeta. Go Big Chub. Celtic Cross is good, but I'd rather have the HP for in case we do find a devil deal that does have, like, you know, all of those demon judgments. If that was Trisagion, I would have taken it, for the record. I would have taken Trisagion. I wouldn't have wussed out in that one. Now, the subject of TM Trainer came up over the course of over the last episodes, and people were asking, you know, am I going to be obligated to take am I going to be obligated to take TM Trainer? The answer is yes. If we do find TM Trainer, I will indeed take it. Even though it is a very dangerous item, it's not a lethal item. Can it be lethal? Oh, yeah, absolutely. For sure. But it's not the same as, like, us saying, like, we got plan C or something like that. You know, I think that it is fair to take TM Trainer because it doesn't... It won't kill you, or at least I don't think it will, just flat out, just from taking it, unless we just get a really bad roll. By the way, still looking for an item room. I want to point that out. I'm not just sitting here ranting and just exploring aimlessly here. I've literally only been looking for an item room. So yeah, if we do come across TM Trainer, I will be obligated to take it, just like any other passive item. Take a little spear. Come on, a little spear. See if I can cut the corner there on that that big room. So yeah, 14 minutes, 40 seconds into this run here. We're ready to go for an easy boss rush. It's been super hot lately. Been drinking lots of water, trying to keep hydrated. I love my fancy water, man. We talked about it before, like... You know, I'm not a water snob. I mean, I'll drink water from the tap. I don't care. But I do like chilling a high quality. Speak of the devil, ye shall appear. And there goes our conquest pony as well. And now we're getting hit with the movement speed down. God, look at our shot speed, though. The shot speed from Binge Eater on Cursed Eye is incredible. It definitely does not take us long to charge stuff up. In fact, I can basically just tap fire. We shouldn't get teleported unless we get hit with a constant beam of damage, like a brimstone shot from Abyss or something like that. Verp and it gave us I Can See Forever, which gave us the map compass and blue map effect as well as the x-ray visions effect. That is incredible. That is really, really nice. Gotta say, shout out to I Can See Forever horse pills. That was our second horse pill that we took, so we're due for the horse transformation, which is a thing, by the way. So Cursed Eye, if you didn't know, will teleport us if we take damage while the shot is charging up. Now, our tears rate is high enough now, which is crazy to even say in this run at this point with the way that we started. Our tears rate is high enough now where I can actually pulse fire. Oh, my goodness. I can actually pulse fire Cursed Eye, but now with now that we've got Mutant Spider, oh my goodness. This is about to get all kinds of crazy. I'm gonna take another binge eater. Just slow our movement speed down even more. Now let's see what our tiers look like here. Yeah, that is extremely powerful. Notice how we did not get a tiers down with quad shot either. Oh man. And we also have 20/20. This is a cursed eye. Now, even if like this was a regular run, this would be an amazingly powerful combo that I would be totally for. Cursed eye with multi-shot is just stupid. Take the negative here. We'll go into the angel room. Oh my Gertie. Holy mantle and toe as well, and we are looking. It's starting to get out of control in a hurry, y'all. Oh my god. And we get Poly freaking Femus as well. Yowza. Okay. Poly freaking Femus on top of everything else. This is a this run turned into something extraordinary. Gotta say. So, and this is the kind of results that I was hoping for when we were talking about all items taken week. I mean, obviously people are going to be wanting the wacky and kooky and, you know, and sort of embarrassingly bad runs because they just like that sort of thing. But this is also the type of fun we can have. Because, I mean, let's be honest, your boy wouldn't be taking Cursed Eye on, you know, all willy-nilly style, but I'm glad I did. Yeah, the doppelganger wasn't even firing because, like, we weren't technically firing any tears there. Wow. Polyphemus on top of Binge Eater, on top of this shot speed that we got. You put in the pseudo piercing of Polyphemus, and we're gonna be murdering things. Now the downside, obviously, Binge Eater destroyed our movement speed, so I'm hoping that we can get some of that back. But if we don't, if we happen to have a hard dodge or two that we can't make, that's where the Holy Mantle is gonna be able, to, or the Holy Relic, I should say, Holy Mantle will be able to help us out. Forever. It perks. And outside of the initial tears down, our pills have not been that horrible either. I have a feeling this is the right way to go. Okay. It's just gas. It's fine. Yeah, it's been super hot lately. I think that most people around the world have been noticing that. And, at least on this side of the world, anyway. I've been enjoying my bougie water. I like me some Fiji water. Like water in general just tastes so good when it's like not like super cold, like ice cold, but like, you know, really really hard chilled. I would say it's almost unbeatable. Just a good bottle of cold water, man. When you're parched, it's like heaven. I mean, just look at the shot speed on this is just insane. Oh, I love it. Can't get to that, unfortunately. Cardio coin, it's gonna, with this movement speed, it's gonna take us 10 years to get that, so I'm not even worried about it. Yeah. well, we get Binge Eater or Binge Eater, so I guess we'll just take Binge Eater. And yeah, we'll take a Guppy item here and we'll take a Binge Eater, and sure, we'll take our Ocular Rift because we don't usually take it. I actually don't think that we need to take Binge Eater anymore. Truth be told, because our tiers rate is maxed out. There's not really any obvious reason why we should take any more Binge Eater stuff. Because we don't need damage. Like, our damage is solid. even without the Binge Eater buff, our damage is going to be solid. Yeah, we got our luck upgrade. Holy Mantle giving us free entry into the curse rooms. Oh my god. Just ocular rift after ocular rift. I mean, it probably helps that our luck is 8.68. That's the reason why they're just proccing nonstop. There's the entire south side of the map, everyone, in case you're interested. But yeah, if you didn't see the first impressions video of Tiny Folks, definitely check it out. Okay, well, there's the entire map. Definitely check it out. It's a neat little game for only $4, too. Like, I was thoroughly impressed by it. Yeah, it's rooms like this where Holy Mantle was made for us because of our bad movement speed. Just giving us that little bit of protection, a little bit of damage mitigation goes a long way. Lots of chests too, despite not having Guppy's tail. We do finally get a movement speed upgrade here. And down goes Mom's heart. And yeah, I think we can do a first lap old Hushy. Why not? Old Hushy. Now, on the subject of re-rolling, I didn't really mention re-rolling because I didn't really truly even think about it. But I don't think I should be forced to re-roll. Take Keybum. Keybum would be the lesser of the two likely ones that I would be taking. We have to take Myosotis. I'll take Mom's bottle of pills just because. We are not taking Hematemesis. Thankfully, we've already discovered it. And we'll take Pokego. Put some money back in the donation machine here. But yeah, on the subject of re-rolling, I don't think that I should be forced to re-roll, especially since, like, the whole novelty of this week is going to be, like, items that I normally wouldn't be taking. Take a fool card. Take that fool card. So yeah, so I think that's fair, you know, because we might get some very interesting combos like the one we have right now, and then like saying like yeah, but you're forced to reroll is kind of lame. I mean, just look at the shots, that's insane. I think that we do get more DPS by me just tap firing though. Now here's the thing with Ocular Rift. Ocular Rift is a complete counter, like super hard counter to Hush. Because it just sucks up all the shots. Like, we don't have to worry about any of them, including the continuum shots. Really, the only thing we have to worry about from Hush is going to be the waterfalls, and that's it. And because our luck rating is so high, like, we're always going to have Ocular Rifts around them. Yeah, I mean, this is... they're being sucked backwards. That's how many rifts there are. Like, Hush is trying to fire those in the opposite direction. Yeah, see? even the doppelgangers aren't going to be able to move. And we don't even have to move for that. We can just let the Holy Mantle take the first shot and let the waterfalls just circle around us. Wow, absolutely dominating. Oh man, just seeing them conga line their way into the spikes. You know, like Ocular Rift, I don't like Ocular Rift by itself just because it is a very annoying and dangerous item. It can put you in really, really bad situations. It's Speaking of speed up, yes, it will.
Speed up! Speed up!
Thank you, Matthias. So we are recovering slowly but surely from our lack of movement speed thanks to Binge Eater. A couple of really, really powerful speed upgrades here. I'm going straight to Stanley as well, I tell you what. Isaac, we gotta talk about your face at some point. I'm meaning to discuss this with you. Yeah, that is not a proper face, son. Stanley having absolutely no chance against this build. I don't think anything's gonna have a chance against this build. We are that powerful. Don't really need any of these, to be honest. I wouldn't even take Maw of the Void. The only one I will take is Spirit of the Night. I mean, yes, technically, I guess we could take the other ones for Binge Eater, but as I said before, I don't think that we need to take any more Binge Eater. Honestly. Truthfully, I really don't. We don't need the tears, and our damage is already incredible. Take a cancer item here, which is going to give us a... very nice HP buff. Oops, I actually meant to take Black Hole there. There you go. We took a hit for that. I'm gonna walk out and walk back in to refresh our Holy Mantida. And I'm gonna do it one more time in case we get sucked into the spike rocks. Take Kidney Bean as well as Blood Puppy. I meant to take Bobby Bombs there. Yeah, I gotta say we're operating from a very, very net positive on terms of pills and all that kind of stuff. So, Sissy, little Sissy, coming out. For day number two of All Items Taken Week, Haunt has no idea what's going on at this point. Get data miner. We never got to use the kidney bean, which is not that big of a deal. Little sissy. Coming out in droves. Get the bean. Died before I can get the toot off on him. And we get baby Fruity Plum. Take Bloody Gust. Yeah, this is just a Cthulhu nightmare here with this Ocular Rift. Need to get far away from things in this room. Take the analog stick, which doesn't really mean a whole lot for us at this point. You're seeing a little bit of the defensive nature too, all kidding aside, of Ocular Rift. You know, we were trapped in that corner with Monstro 2 and he was about to fire, and Ocular Rift just took all the tears and was like, nope. Yeah, we're going to do a victory lap. That was a good lap. A lot of fun. Good first run. 6 Romeo, 7 1. Sierra Hotel, 6 Kilo. So we do get all new pills here on this run. And a whole new suite of items that we're going to have to plow through, but because we got little sissy, doesn't even matter. I'm going to exit real quick because I'm victory laps for some odd reason. I don't know why, but some followers just freak the hell out. And you saw Multidimensional Baby kind of doing that, and I don't want to give people seizures looking at him. Oh, man. Deep pockets as well. Half price binge eater. I'll take the half price binge eater just for a little bit more damage. And luck down. All right. That's going to change the way that. That's going to change. Little spewer as well. We got a snack, and yeah, we can go old alt path here. Why not? I mean, we've got plenty of upgrades. And let's go ahead. Well, let's start off with a blind item. I was gonna say let's go ahead and just take all the blind item side, but now they're both blind item sides. So this is only downpour one. We don't have to worry about the knife piece yet. Love those sideways fade there by the water leeches. Little blub, like a little dead. Don't know which one we're taking. Nah. That's the only downside to binge eater now is that we just don't know when. I don't have the timing on that, so. So maintaining a good amount of money here as well. I truthfully do not want Binge Eater. I don't want to drop our movement speed anymore. But I just can't stop taking it for some reason. The one time we don't want Binge Eater. That's all right. We'll be able to see on the next floor, hopefully. Okay. Now we should be able to see... We should be able to see what we're getting for items here. Bloody Gust is activating, so I'll take the pact here because we're gonna get damage either way. Get the Leviathan transformation, which doesn't really matter at this point. Let's go into silly me. Our shot speed is out of control. Gonna be super fan. We're gonna take Dead Onion, which is actually not a bad upgrade for us. I mean, I'll take the I'll take the spectral piercing shots for sure. Got the knife piece. We can go get a second boss item here. We might as well go do that. Yeah, take that, Wormwood, you jerk. How about some more shot speed for us here? Secret room should be here. Super secret room. Oh, yeah, that was the super secret room. Never mind. All right, round two, Wormwood. Actually torn asunder by the strength of our shot speed. This is just getting out of control in a hurry. I mean, Polyphemus pretty much sent us over the map, but this shot speed is just, it's something special. And the fact that we got cursed eye, it doesn't even feel like it's even more crazy. Unfortunately, we did lose all of our movement speed that we had gained through Bloody Gust. So hopefully we have some way of getting it back. Get the D-Izzle. Take the range up. Well, we lowered our speed by even more. So pretty happy about that. Let's try that again, D8. Okay, well, we lost 5 tiers. So kind of showing you why nobody likes the D8 anymore. I mean, like, we're still, like, we still do be zooming, though. But not quite, not as hard as we were. Okay, we gained some of our tiers back. More importantly, we gained movement speed. Oh my god. So that's what happens when we get teleported with the cursed eye, by the way. You need to be careful with Ocular Rift, apparently. There we go. I'll take Benjeater and head on Dizown. All right. Here's to hoping that we can get a good D8 roll. Really, all I want is just to gain, like, just put me at, like, 1.3 movement speed, and I'll be happy with that. Lost our tiers again. Balls of Steel was just nothing for us. Well, we found our 2 golden buttons pretty quickly, so let's go get the... We might as well go get the knife piece while we can, since we're here. Yeah, and welcome back to our old tiers rate from so long ago, it seems like. 42 minutes ago. We got little Sissy waiting for us. Don't worry, Sissy, we'll be there. There was a tinted rock in that room, but we don't have any bombs to use, so it doesn't really matter. This is where a bad tiers rate actually does kind of hurt you. There we go. A keeper sack. Nun's habit wouldn't be bad either for us. I'll take a death card as well. They were just shifting through so many stats here. It's amazing that we're not getting a whole lot of movement speed. Modeling clay should also provide some lulls here. Hey, hallowed ground. So yeah, we did find an upper limit of how many binge eaters I care about before I just don't care anymore. And the mystery's been solved. Oh, it's going to be Clutch. And there he goes. I'm gonna take that for the shot speed. Just so we have more stats to roll with. Okay, let's see where our movement speed ended up here. Because remember, we gained stats from Bloody Gust. Okay, yeah, you know, we got stats. We got some movement speed finally. It's not the speed that we like, but it's what we got. Now, I am a little bit mad that we don't have, like, crazy high fire rate anymore. So I may still be re-rolling. I mean, the D8 is always going to be a gamble. It's usually a gamble you're going to lose. Curse of the Maze now, thanks to Forgotten. That's Essence. Okay, we gained our crazy fire rate back, which I'm fine with. Eden's Blessing. We're going to take Polydactyl instead. Experimental Pills gave us a speed down, of course. All the steel doesn't really matter. I love that Super Greed was like, all right, I've got him right where I want him. I'm going to fire this volley of shots, and it's going to pierce his soul. And then Ocular Rift just makes it like he was just shooting into like a fan. Kind of tears up. We'll take a range up here. Man, Vade Retro is going to have to replace our D8, which is fine by me because like the D8 was just screwing us left and right, but Vade Retro can be a good item. It's not an item you see me use all that often because I don't think it's good, but it can be if you get the right amount of explosion. So what it does is it will turn any enemy that you kill into red ghosts that will do almost like a Bomber Boy-esque type of explosion around it. And it also provides the benefits of Purgatory, which is that it's going to consume any shots around the explosion. But the problem is that like it's very, very often not going to be the explosions are not going to be anywhere near like where you want them to be most of the time, not all the time, but most of the time. And we can say goodbye to Vade Retro. Okay, let's go back and go find the item room here. Now, we could actually use Binge Eater once again, as crazy as it is to say, because that last D8 roll, like, was not good for our damage. Our damage has gone way, way, way down. We were doing double of what we have right now before that D8 roll, so, you know, Binge Eater might be back on the plate. You can see how we're not killing things anywhere near as fast as we were. We're still killing things, to be sure, but not at the rate that we had grown accustomed to. There's no reason for us to take Almond Milk. Plus, I already committed to taking all the blind items. Eagle's power wouldn't be a bad thing. I should be picking up all these though. Now that I think about it, all the money, because we've got Keeper Sack. And there is a reroll machine, so this is the last floor as well that has a store on it. So I need to be picking up this money. Talk about missing damage, and then we don't utilize Keeper Sack. Now that's a Sinvicta logic right there. I'll buy a little baggie just because pills. Got another Balls of Steel pill. Benjeter. I think that's a treasure map. Remember, we're doing this just to gain some of our damage back that we had. And we increase our damage at a decent rate here. Oh, I forgot to go into the Super Secret Room. My bad. Down goes Mama, and we got a, we did get a boss rush. Ooh, man. Tech X, is that gonna, that's not gonna fire with 7.62 tiers, though. Yeah, this is actually not that great. In fact, it's considerably worse now because of Cursed Eye. It's still firing at a good rate here, don't get me wrong, but not as high as it was with just regular Cursed Eye. Dizzy, always tearing it up for us. Appreciate that. You go, girl. try dodging that one. Now, I don't know if the... I'm not sure if Tech X cancels out the Cursed Eye effect. I'm almost 90% sure it doesn't. I could be wrong. Oh my god, 10. We get the wafer as well. So yeah, all in all, I'd say day two of All Items Taken Week turned out to be quite the banger. Cursed Eye and Quad Shot definitely made their presence known. Ocular Rift absolutely crushed Hush and basically anything that was trying to fire tears at us. And honestly, I'm all for it. I am all for it here. Okay, so boss might be on this side here. If we're going off of where the secret rooms are. Get a full health pill. Pills also, again, have not been horrible. Outside of that first tiers down pill that we got to start off the episode, we've been loving it. Gonna be Rotgut. Rotgut is not gonna be happy. But I'm happy, and hopefully you're happy too. And if you are happy today, click the like button for me. If you'd like to keep me happy, make my day, and that'd be a great way to do it. And thank you for those of you who do go do that each and every day. I really appreciate it. 73% to end the Devil Deal chances here as we head on down to Mother and finish this one off. with a Curse of the Blind, which doesn't really even matter at this point. What a run. You know, it has... Sorry, Braille. It definitely has to be said of just how good the multi-shot with Cursed Eye can be. You know, even with Tech X here, which kind of it did kind of ruin our vibe. I thought that I'd be able to pulse fire Tech X like crazy. Didn't quite work out that way. I was kind of hoping so, but it was a great run through and through. So day two in the books here for All Items Taken Week. We had some good times here. We got Little Sissy. We got Ocular Rifts just going off and making just an absolute joke out of anything that's firing shots at us, except for Mother, of course. And one thing we don't want to do is we don't want to get hit during the Mother fight that teleports us out of here, which is going to be easier said than done because of the way that she's kind of jostling around with the Ocular Rift. Kind of like that. But with the amount of time, I mean, we got 20 luck. So, like, with the amount of rifts that we're creating with all of our shots, just projectiles are just a non-issue. What a run. Thank you for watching, everyone. Super duper fun run. Definitely play it for yourself and let me know what happened if you didn't take Tech X in there, if you had some other kind of crazy synergy down below. Like I said, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, all that kind of good stuff. I really do appreciate it, everybody. Thank you for making this week like absolutely possible and absolutely awesome so far. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Greg Davis, Jaegersmon, Ty Hamamoto, Frederick Backstrom, Charleston, and Josue Contreras. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.